Get some other news for you now. The Libyan government has accused NATO of killing 85 civilians in an air raid on a village in the west of the country. Government officials took journalists, among them our correspondent Matthew Price, to see destroyed buildings in Majar, east of the capital Tripoli. The pictures filmed under very strict supervision of the Libyan government, which says that the village had no strategic value. Now, NATO says it struck a military facility there. You may find some of the images in Matthew's report distressing.
Under the fierce summer sun, they came to bury their dead. Civilians, they told us, more than 20 in all at this mass funeral. The anger against NATO was clear. At the site of the airstrike itself, they told us they were digging to remove the bodies of two children. There was evidence of normal life here. School books lay in the rubble.
It is hard to know if NATO did strike this area, exactly what its strategic value was, but the Libyan government is telling us that there was no strategic value here, that it was purely a civilian target.
NATO said it struck a site south of Zlatan, a military staging area for pro-Gaddafi forces. It said it has no evidence of civilian casualties. At the mortuary in Zlatan, they showed us about 30 bodies. Most were young men of fighting age, but they held up a dead two-year-old. There was another child and also two women. In the hospital, we found 15-year-old Salwa Jawu. Her name was on the school books at the destroyed buildings. There was no military camp. We were just living there. Why did they attack us? She asked. Her grief was genuine. But precisely how many civilians were injured and killed here is still unclear. Matthew Price, BBC News, Zlatan.